Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be my fall project wax finale and also my winter project wax introduction. So I figured I'd just combine them into the same video because I'm kind of carrying over most of the ones that are left to the rest of the project wax. So I'm just gonna carry them over. And yeah, let's go ahead and start with reviewing all the ones that I finished up during the fall project wax. We're gonna start off with that. Okay, so first I finished up two single wicks during the fall project wax. The first one is Autumn. This was an amazing scent. I had this one from last year. A beautiful juicy red apple, outdoorsy kind of scent. Just amazing. I would definitely buy that one again. And then Frosted Cranberry from last year in the wintertime. Progress lines, I guess I'll show you. Started out last month here and then just finished it up. Amazing, amazing, amazing juicy scent. Really loved it in the bathroom. It actually threw super well and it was an amazing scent. So that's it for single wicks. Let's move on to some other candles. We have the Huntington Homes Toasted Pumpkin Marshmallow Candle. You can see this one was very sooty. And this is my progress from the last month to now. I finished it up, burned all the way down. I got kind of scared because it is a wood wick, so I didn't burn it like all the way until it burned itself out, but got really far down and I loved this scent. It was definitely like a bonfire kind of scent. It had smokiness to it, which I honestly didn't mind too much. It was a good scent. It lasted for a while, and for like maybe $6 from Aldi, it was a really, really good candle. Another one from Aldi that I just finished is the Pumpkin Apple Fritter. And this one burned, this was where it was last month and I burned it all the way down. This one again didn't go all the way until it like burned itself out because I got a little concerned. I've never used Aldi candles up like all the way down before, so I just stopped burning it. Also, it had no scent left once it got to the very bottom, but it was a good scent while I had it. I would try not to buy Aldi candles because I didn't notice it had the best throw, but it wasn't bad for $4. So I would probably purchase them again, but not as many as I would purchase from like Bath & Body Works. So it was a good scent, but nothing crazy. From Yankee Candle Home Classics Collection, this is Vanilla Chai. I had this one going in the candle crock actually for a few months, and you could still smell it in my room. I even took it off the candle crock and you could still kind of smell it, but it wasn't super strong, so I just took it off. But yeah, this one was a good scent in the crock. It threw absolutely nothing when I burned it. It was a single wick. Probably won't pick these up again. I just noticed the one wick ones from Yankee don't throw that well. It's also just like a vanilla scent, so it wasn't going to be strong anyways because it's vanilla, but those are the scents I like. Another chai scent is the Toasted Vanilla and Chai from Bath & Body Works. This one I pretty much solely, I burned it like once or twice and then I put it in the candle crock. And it performed really well in there. It lasted for like a month and a half. I just left it on in my room like pretty much at all times and it was really good. Can't smell it anymore. I probably would never pick this up again because it was a horrible performer. Literally no scent unless I put it on the candle crock. So yeah, not gonna purchase that one again. The next one that I have is Warm Apple Pie. This one was an online exclusive from the fall. Here's where it was last month, right up here. And I burned it down all the way during the past month. Oh, this scent was amazing. It definitely smelled like juicy apple pie. Almost kind of like cherry pie, more so than apple in my opinion, but it was a really, really good pie scent. I adored it. It was so good. The only bad thing was it had those very, very thin wicks, so it couldn't last in my bedroom because I keep my fan on all the time. So I had to burn it in my bathroom, which was like kind of weird having an apple pie scent in the bathroom, but that was like the only way I could get it to actually burn in there because there's little to no airflow. So yeah, that was a little odd, but the scent was like absolutely amazing. I would still pick it up again next year. And the last one that I actually finished off today is Pumpkin Vanilla Creme. It was all the way up here whenever I had it in last month and I pretty much burned it all the way down. It burned itself out today. This was a good scent, but it had that jalapeno chip smell, which is like super odd. So if it has that smell again on cold next year, I'm not going to pick it up. But if it doesn't, then I will. But it was a nice scent. It still smelled like pumpkin cream, but with like a jalapeno scent. So that was kind of odd. Yeah, not sure how I felt about that. Let's review some ones that I have progress on since the last month. So we will start off with Goose Crink's Toasty Pumpkin Toddy, which I've had since last year. I'm going to go ahead and mark it. So I used this a ton in the last month. I've been like transitioning it between my bathroom and my bedroom because this actually has a really good scent in the bathroom because it's basically like apple cider. So with actually like a little bit of maple to it though, but this is the progress that I made in the last month, which is like really good for these jar candles because they take a lot to finish, but such a good juicy scent. I probably would pick this up again next fall. Because it was really good, and this one was not super sooty, which their jar candles are notorious for being very sooty, but this one really wasn't. So I've been really, really enjoying this one. Oh, and all these ones that I'm going to mention from now on are going into the winter project. So here's the beginning of the winter project, okay? So yeah, this one's definitely staying in for the winter. The next one I have is Citrus Clove from Huntington Homes. I also got some progress on this since last month. I put it in at unused the last month, and I have used it quite a bit. So here is that progress, and you'll notice there's a lot of wax buildup on the side and I can't get it to go. But the toasty pumpkin marshmallow one did the exact same thing to me. After it got about the midway point, it started to melt all the stuff like tunneled on the sides, but yeah, that's kind of annoying, but it's okay because I actually like the scent. It's just straight up clove. I don't get too much citrus from it, but it's pretty good. I'm keeping this one also in for the winter, and I'm gonna try and finish it up. My goal is really to not have any more autumn candles carrying over to next year, so I'm gonna try and finish them all off in the winter. So this one's going in. The next one I have is White Pumpkin. This one was like a freebie online with some certain purchase, but yeah, this one was free to me, and this is the progress that I got in the last month. Not too much progress, but that's okay. I really like this scent. It's perfect for when it's actually cold outside. So I'm actually super excited to have this going into December because in Texas, it really doesn't get cold until like after Thanksgiving, if that, and cold for us is like 60s. So yeah, I'm really excited to keep this one in and finish it off in the winter. So next I have Leaves, and this one's from 2019, I think. Yeah, 2019, so it is an old one and I definitely need to finish it up. Here is the progress that I made in the last month. It is just like a super strong powerhouse, so I've had some troubles using it just in my bedroom. So I think I'm going to focus this one mainly in the bathroom in the next month and try and finish it off. So this one is absolutely staying in for the winter. This next one is Pumpkin Bonfire, also one of my favorites. This is the progress since last month. This one also is a really good one to do when it's actually cold outside because it gives you those like warm, cozy feelings. Ooh, it's so nice. So I am absolutely keeping this one in for the winter project, and I feel like this will be actually better to do in winter than it was in fall. So really, really happy about this one. Definitely gonna keep trying to finish that one up. And then the last one that I have progress on is Banana Walnut Muffin. And here's my progress since the last month, right about here. I do have like a little bit of tunneling going on, but not too much. And I actually just finished burning this a few hours ago, maybe 30 minutes ago. But it is like a super, super spicy bakery scent. So perfect for this time of year. I am going to keep it in for the winter. I'm not super pressed about using this one up. If this is the only fall scent that I bring over to next year, then I'm totally fine with that because it's not like super duper fall. I could honestly use it any time of year. It's just like a bakery scent. All right, let's get started on some new things that I'm adding into the project. So I have a few that are like actually Christmas, and then I have a few that are continuing on the fall train. So the first one on the fall train is Cinnamon Irish Cream, which actually this one's coming out for Candle Day, so I guess it's not like too much of a fall item. So it can apply to the winter as well, but we're starting it off. I have burned it a little bit, so here is the marking. We're starting it off right here. This one, it's really just like a cinnamon buttercream kind of scent. The scent notes are cinnamon, spice liqueur, Irish cream, and French vanilla. So yeah, it's just like a spicy vanilla bakery scent. So yeah. I didn't really use this at all last year, so I'm gonna try and finish it up this year, but I feel like this will be really good when it's super cold outside. The next fall scent that I have is actually Pumpkin Pie, which the only time I burned this last year was on Thanksgiving Day, so I have one burn on it, so it started off pretty much unburned. But yeah, this one legit smells like pumpkin pie when you're burning it. I just wanna get some progress on it. I know it's probably unrealistic to try and finish this up in the next month, but I do want to get some progress on it because I know that I can with these jar candles. So I'm just going to get some progress on it, and I'm totally okay to carry this over. But yeah, we're just going to start on this one this month. The next one I have is a little bit odd, but it is the Love Everybody Sweet Carrot Cake. Everybody went insane over this during the spring last year. I wasn't the biggest fan of it during spring because it is super cinnamony and like so spicy, but the scent notes are sweet cream cheese frosting, fluffy carrot cake, and cinnamon spice. And for those of you that don't know, carrot cake is really just spice cake with carrots shavings in it. So yeah, it's basically just spice cake with like a little bit of icing. And yeah, so I definitely meant to keep this and open it in fall and start using it again in the fall, but I kind of forgot about it. So I'm gonna put it in for the winter and hopefully get some progress on it while it's cold. So that's Love Every Bunny. We're starting it off right about here. So a little more than a third of the way through. So that's that one. The next one I have is Tis the Season. And I actually got this this past year at SAS in the summer. So it is unused. I've never burned it before, but this is one of my favorite winter scents. It is rich red apple, sweet cinnamon, cedarwood. It's just like a spicy red apple scent. It is so yummy. Definitely reminds me of Christmas time. So very excited to have this one in, which is like a true Christmas scent. So there's like kind of the first true Christmas scent coming into the winter project. The next Christmas scent is Twisted Peppermint, and this one's really old. The date code is 2018, so it is an old one. I have burned it a little bit, but here is the like line of where we're starting it at in the project, and it's just like a nice peppermint scent. So yeah, probably gonna aim this one for the bathroom and try and finish it up in the bathroom, but it's like a really nice, just fresh minty scent. So really excited about this one. I'm definitely gonna try and finish it because it's really old. So 3 years old is too old for me to keep in my collection. And the last one that I'm putting in the project is Peppermint Bark from DW Homes. I am obsessed with this packaging. I bought it last year at Marshall's for $7.99, and I just love this mirrored red packaging. I think it's so Christmassy and beautiful, and it is a single wick. We have a little bit of progress on it. You can see I definitely have burned it before, but not a lot. So it smells exactly like peppermint bark, but it is on the lighter side. But yeah, I definitely want to get it finished up this winter because I bought it last winter, and you know, I just don't want to keep things in my collection for too long. So yeah, gonna be focusing on peppermint bark. So that's everything for the winter project wax intro. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Let me know down below, what are you most excited about using for your fall candles? For me, it's definitely Tis the Season, and I can predict that after candle day I'm gonna try and add a lot more candles to this. So there might be an update come like mid-December on this candle project, because I can just imagine I want to start using all those candle day candles really soon. So that might be coming soon, but just keep a lookout. Go ahead and subscribe and turn on post notifications so you'll get notified. But yeah, that's everything for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye.